Coming up next, Steve, Machabo versus Summit Chip. And Machabo, you know, I got to be honest with you, Steve. Damn, what a Michael Knott got to say. I don't give a shit. You got to understand, Machabo is a player that was handpicked by Daigo himself last year. He said, straight up, if I run an exhibition, if I put my name on some shit, I want players who make me want to be better. He said, I want to watch the best.
Okay.
And he hand-selected out of the entire Guilty Gear community, not even out of the Guilty Gear community, out of fighting games. He said, this player makes me want to. When he watches Machabo play, he said that he, in situations where he doesn't know the answer, Machabo, Mr. Saitekika, he knows all the answers and he has the best one every time. That was the praise that Daigo Umehara put on this guy. And when he challenges foe, his rival, Ogawa, right, in that first attempt.
Yes.
A lot of people, you know, a lot of people don't talk about the Guilty Gear sets when they talk about sets of the year, tournament matches of the year, whatever, man. That was one of the best sets of that year, for sure. And Machabo was able to play Ogawa in loser's and winner's side, overcome his opponent in tournament here today, despite taking the loss in that exhibition.
Well, look, also his opponent, Summit, the chip, right? Yeah. The chip to watch. We talked about the changes that have happened since Exert, where Chip has changed so drastically, but still one of those characters that once he gets started, it is almost impossible to get him away from you. He has really good open steel. I mean, just the pressure he's able to put on you, those teleports, and this man has been doing it for quite some time. He knows how to keep it going, and he's rocking the classic green and white outfit. That's how you know who you're looking at. But yeah, man, Chip is one of those characters you have to be aware of. You're going to be scared to do a lot more DPs in this situation because Chip is going to be everywhere except for where you need him to be.
That's right, Walker Gaming Summit, Chip. Longtime Chip player, finally getting here at this Evo Japan Top 8 stage. And look, Steve, this character can move, bro. This character, the screen is his playground. He can go anywhere, do anything, but he's going up against Machabo Kai.
He runs across the country to get to start the banging. Come on, man. This is a ninja right here, man. I can't believe you said you wanted a forearm blade. We all be dead, man, including you. All right, here we go. Game number one.
So the big thing, Steve, we got to talk about these characters, right? Chip, he has every tool in the book, but at the cost of HP. He has very low health. Does have some guts, but you got to be very careful about the hits that you take with this character. And Kai in particular has some big counter hit damage buttons that down heavy.
Well, you can tell right now. See, you can tell right now that he's playing a lot safer. He wants to get that knockdown before he starts swinging because if Chip gets a hit first, it's going to be a lot harder for him to get him off. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. Now, either you're going to burst or you're going to stay here. Ooh, nice against the S. He's got a burst.
No, he pins him.
Stays in the corner
back
still.
To him. Off the wall, gets him high on the other side.
See, and that's another one of the mechanics that they added. The fact that you can take that blitz and use it to stop that burst, that really helps out for the later meta of Guilty Gear now. A lot of people have just recently started getting into it, but we've seen it a lot here in the Japan side.
And that's been dubbed now the Summit Burst. He will give up those bad bursts. That's going to be a point of contention that Machabo maybe is looking to capitalize on.
Look at that conversion right there. A lot of times you're going to see these Chip players get those teleports, hit a falling H, and still be ready to convert with a stand jab into a 2H.
You see him. He wants to stay out of that Kai far slash range. Kai has those big, long, sword stabby normals like that that cover a lot of range and can lead to big things. Or he just goes up, gets a throw in the corner, and is able to close out the round for it. The big thing for Chip is also using Gamma Blade at that range as well, right? If you can cut off that ground lane, force Kai to move through the air, he does have some very big sword normals in the air as well that jump heavy slash, you just saw it. But it can open up the opportunity for Summit to be able to go up, get a grab, and then start Okizeme of his own.
And it's all about getting that knockdown too sometimes, like right here. It's going to give you a nice little mix-up. You can jump, nice back dash right there. But you spoke about that. Once Kai gets that knockdown, holding you on the ground is what he wants to do. You talked about Chip being able to play whenever he wants to. That's why you don't want him to get started. And I like that teleport to the other side just to make sure he gets the corner. Back dash 6B, catches the purple YRC, and you're still going to stay in that corner.
It's something that's going to be important for this matchup that someone has been showing you. He's leveraging a lot of his meter.
Yo, did you see the 2K?
Yep.
Oh, that was so sick. After the Shuriken Super, and Summit takes that first game, and he is looking comfortable. I mean, playing with a character like Chip, knowing that it's so viable. Like, if you get hit, you're going to explode, is something that Summit has all. He's been born, bred, and he's been doing this for years.
It's one reason why he favors the swing, right? You're more likely to get that knockdown. You're more likely to get what you need. You're less likely to be put on your back.
Nice 2S right there. Tries to get the dust on top of it. Air throw after the just guard. Okay.
Bad DP, no punish. You see Machimo showing off his air control, right? Those instant blocks in the air, going for the air throw after. That is a perfect solution to that kind of offense that Summit wants to run. That's why he was selected by Daigo. That's why we wanted to see him at Kimono Michi. But right now, Summit going to get him in the air, DP Ender. Now that's the thing, Chip isn't going to be able to convert into knockdown in a lot of those situations if he wants to end a DP like that, but he's going to be able to reposition him, set himself up for another pickup. John Cena mode.
You ain't blocking this. Because it's a throw.
Gets the grab, gets the pick.
Yo,
Summit is on set point against Machimo.
And he is going fast.
Yeah.
Ninjas move fast. Let's go. All or nothing. Teleport once again. But yeah, those instant blocks are really important. And you're going to see him do jump back H, jump back S, to kind of anticipate it, because you do not want him to be on top of you and you don't have the DP to answer back. Instant block throw is going to be really, really strong, but you still got to anticipate it. It's not easy. Whoa, but I mean, I'm sorry. Nice. Gets the whip on the RP, still gets the air throw, but now Chip in the corner. Summit needs to be careful. Far S gets the stun different. Pressure, nice 6K.
This is what Machimo wants, right? Try to lock him down in the corner as much as possible. Summit able to break that offensive pressure and be able to get back to mid-screen. It's a jump D, gets the knockdown, bait, punish on the dead angle with a throw.
Find me. Nice pressure. Sushi. Oh, nice. Tries to go for the air throw. I like that. Machimo saw what happened last time, decides to jump back.
Yeah, double jumped out of range. Saw Summit trying to leverage his gauge there, right? In a situation where Kai wants to jump up in the air, it's easy for him to just YRC, go up in the air grab, get a knockdown.
They get him spin that burst so early. Gets the air through again, stuck in the corner. It's not a good situation. We talked about the guts. It's not going to matter. Machimo getting back control. 43 seconds still left on the clock, but now you see what Kai has to do to make sure a player like Summit is not going to be
and
in control.
And that's one reason why he wants to stay out of that far S range, right? Very easy for Machimo's Kai to be able to just confirm in a 30% sequence just like that.
Right, and then this guess right here is really dangerous. He does not have to go for throw. He can run up, do stand kick, nice DP right there. He can run up, just make sure he keeps that pressure going. Another teleport. See this man, and the green is blending in with the shrubbery in the back.
Oh, let your hair down.
Uh-oh.
They changed the track up on you too, jump kick conversion. We just teched him with the jump D, gets him to the wall. Meter building.
Oh, the golf swing.
Yeah, that's three heavy.
Need to get out of there, and another air throw. Now you see Machimo making those adjustments. Knows that he's going to try to jump out because he does not want to hold that mix up after Big Blue. He does not want to have to deal with that fireball pressure. Up back, still gets him caught. Machimo takes the game.
That one little thing makes such a big difference and changes a lot of the situations that were giving Summit the advantage in those early game, in those early rounds, right? Denying him those situations, now forcing a little bit more neutral as a result. Machimo's taking slowly but steadily taking control.
I like what he's doing.
Oh, other side, max range stand kick conversion.
Makes him spin that burst early. You want to keep Chip up off of you. And on top of that, the fact that Chip hits you so many times means you're going to get access to more bursts.
Teleport sweep, what a beast. Drop him at the wall, hit you on the other side with that falling heavy. Drill kick on down, max range dust. That thing hits way further than you think it does.
Oh, wow, that was so
dirty. Alpha plus to push him back to the wall.
Oh, nice DP this time.
Get those daggers out of my face. Hold on. Here comes Machimo with the yes. Willing to burn his meter off that jump heavy.
Wow. I can't believe that five does missed in the air. Machimo
gets the throw in the corner as reward.
Burst. Look, that was a goal burst.
Yeah, goal burst.
Alpha counter plus to push him. Oh, wow. We're not close enough. Yo, that faultless defense fall is so helping out Chip. I did not even see this man. OTG.
And those punches there. That was the situation we were talking about earlier, right? Kai has a little bit of guts. At that point, Summit just wants the OTG get as many hits as possible to close out the round. And that's big. He needed to win that round. The close one like that, you can't give that up to Machimo.
He did teleport, stand and swift, teleport back, sweep. That's how he got in right now.
The forward punch conversion on the ground. Other side, heavy. Take up to the skies. Aerial rave.
Hey, aerial rave. Let's go.
Game's building.
It's the wall
stick. Me again. And it's the play around the text, too. That's what this game boils down to in a lot of high-level matchups.
Oh, 6P.
Full screen 6P. And the meter, we got it.
Oh, yeah.
Is he going to do it?
Ninja Maximilian, daggers.
You need your heart out. Ninja daggers. Machimo dropped in the loser's bracket by Summit Chip.
That's the second time. I know, man. Look, we're getting hype and we keep knocking down the Nissan. Can we get a Nissan Cup Noodle organized over here?
Can we get a spotter?
Can I get a re-rack on my cup noodles? Can I get a re-rack?